I'm just applying Vaseline. I do overline my lip for them to appear bigger. Sometimes I overline them a bit too much, but the perfect way to overline your lip is to draw it in between your actual lip and the skin. So in the middle, you don't want to go too far out. And clearly underlining them is gonna make them look smaller, so you don't really want to do that. Overline in between, that's gonna give you a much more natural overline look instead of on your actual skin. But if you want a much larger lip, then you would have to go over. Now I'm gonna apply a much lighter nude than what I'm wearing. Face of Australia lipstick in Iced Almond, pure nude shade. And applying that in between. Just making sure edges are still darker. Gonna do is apply a brown eyeliner in my waterline, darken my eyes a little bit, so tight lining as well to make my upper lash line appear fuller. This is just a really natural layer, but it just helps get rid of that fleshy color. As the weather gets hotter, I've been using Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade. This is in dark brown, but it is dry. It dries really quickly, so I'm gonna get a little bit of Vaseline. Brushing up my eyebrows, and yeah. I start off with drawing a line on the bottom, then I blend that up to start filling in the front of my eyebrows. So not using any more products so that it's not as dark. Drawing in fake hairs. See, that's really dry. It needs to like glide on properly. Now fill that in with the rest of the products. Gotta be really careful doing the bottom one because that creates the shape as well. I kind of just go along with how my natural eyebrows are looking. Been bringing it up, filling it in with not much products, and drawing that fake hair that really creates the shape of my eyebrows, and then that tail, and then filling it in. And then the bottom bit, drawing the bottom area with the leftover products. It won't move anyway. Well, my hairs will move, but the product won't because it's waterproof. I'm gonna apply a little bit of liner so that my falsies will blend nicely since I don't have any color on my eyes. It's gonna stand out so much more if I didn't have the liner. Let's pull out our eyes, make it look lifted. We're using the same brown gel liner. So that's kind of dry too, so just taking a little bit of Vaseline and drawing in the line. So ideally it should get thinner. Underneath my eyes, like right underneath the edge, taper it out, then connect it. Set everything with the Australis makeup finishing spritz, but I've placed it on this travel bottle because that spray bottle is broken. It's not spraying properly. Actually, I'm gonna apply my mascara first. Gets rid of that powdery lashes. So I would normally curl my lashes so my fake lashes will have something to sit on, but I don't have one at the moment. So now spraying the rest of my face, locking it in place so it won't move those highlights, those powders on top. Now applying my lashes to just, that's it, to finish off the look. Lashes will do everything. No matter how shitty your like makeup is, when you have lashes, it really just... Okay, so... As I said, it focuses on the face, the skin, enhancing your amazing features, your beauty, and... Baby, please. What do you want? Do you want me to open the door? Let me open the door. He's back. Hi, Sus. How are you doing? You're so pretty. And it looks really like natural, like this darkened version, which is really good for when you do like really light natural makeup. And it's hard to go overboard unless you like try to really draw on your eyebrows and try to like reshape them. You can't, it's not easy with this one. Just any pinkish nude shade.